to this special webinar, which is organized by ConvoSite in association with Exchange for Media. The paradigm of marketing has changed totally, and it has become category specific. Today, the topic of discussion that we have chosen is how are electronic brands innovating in customer reach out channels post COVID-19. So let me put a little bit of context into the association between ConvoSite and E4M. ConvoSite is the largest and most loved platform by community builders and leaders to grow and manage their communities on Facebook. More than 4,000 admins trust ConvoSite to grow and manage over 90 million members in their communities, that is Facebook groups, which is itself a huge number. It also helps brands engage with existing communities, supercharge social listening, purpose-led marketing campaigns, and build communities from scratch. To take on this discussion, we have some experts, some of the top names from the industry. I want to first welcome Mr. Amit Tiwari, who's the Vice President of Marketing, Havells. Mr. Tiwari is a very well-known name. He's an expert, a columnist. He writes all over. The final name when it comes to marketing insights. Welcome, sir, on the panel. We also have with us Mr. Ranjivjit Singh, ex-SVP Samsung, ex-CMO HP and Microsoft. Mr. Singh has led marketing for some of the top consumer electronic brands in India. He comes with a rich experience spanning from mobiles, laptops, computer accessories, you name it. You know, he's there. Welcome, Mr. Singh, to this panel. We also have with us Mr. Sanjay Chitkara, Vice President, Sales Innovation, LG India. He has over 3 decades of rich experience in sales and marketing in companies like Videocon, LG, and others. Welcome, Mr. Chitkara, on the panel. And moving on, I also have Mr. Vaibhav Mishra, Community Head Tech Guru India. Mr. Mishra started Guru in class 10, blogging since college and building tech enthusiast community on Facebook. Tech Guru India has over 47,000 members, reaching very close to the 50K number. And to moderate this discussion, I am privileged to introduce Ms. Tamanna Dhamija, who is joining us literally across continents from the US. She is the CEO and co-founder of ConvoSite. Before building ConvoSite, she has also built India's largest parenting community with over 2 million moms and has been acknowledged as the leader, as a Facebook community leader and certified by Facebook on community building. That is, ladies and gentlemen, the panel in front of you. I hand it over to Ms. Dhamija to take it forward. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much, Rohail, and welcome to all the panelists. Amit, Ranjiv, and Sanjay, very, very happy to be talking to all of you and super pumped to be having this discussion with all of you, and then also Vaibhav, who leads one of India's oldest communities in technology, Tech Guru India, which he started, like Rohail said, when he was in school, inspired by a show on CNBC called Tech Guru. He started a blog, he started a Facebook group, and initially he just had technology enthusiasts and coders in his community. But today there's content creators, there's people who are looking to buy phones or laptops, and very recently also home appliances, who join his community, discuss a lot about what are the best products to buy, what are the softwares. So welcome everyone. Just a little bit about, Rohail has given a good introduction, but a little bit about ConvoSite. I'm an investment banker turned entrepreneur, started my journey by building Facebook groups on parenting, moved from New York to India to build that baby destination, which is today about 2 million members, and then scaled that to build ConvoSite, because I realized there's millions of people building communities, and there's communities that are starting out across categories. So which is why today we are here on electronics or hiking or biking or parenting. And all of these community admins need tools to help build and manage thriving communities. And also brands need tools to discover these communities at scale and access these communities for insights and purpose-led marketing, which is where ConvoSite was born. Whatever we do, we sort of lead it with insights. Consumer electronics is a very, very interesting category. with the change that we all have seen in our lives post this pandemic, right? It is a category which has a different place and position in our lives now. It has become a pull rather than a push. What used to be considered luxury in the past, although discretionary spending has come down, but what used to be considered luxury has now become an essential spending. I wanted to just start, sort of kickstart the discussion by sharing some relevant insights. And I'm going to share my screen for that and just kick it off with some questions. Let me know if my screen is visible.
Yes, it is, Tamanna, it is visible.
Okay, great. So while we are all at home, right? Everything that we're doing at home, we are clearly working at home, right? It's nice to be meeting you all from home, where you're in India, I'm in New York. So we are working from home. We are working at home. We were all in lockdown. We could not have domestic help come to our places. So we were working at home. We are learning from home. Our kids are learning from home. We are cooking a lot at home. Again, we don't have domestic help. There's also a big sort of salon at home concept, right? Because we can, again, not step out. So this, with home being the center, all of these themes have emerged. And what's super interesting is some of the categories, specifically within electronics, that have emerged as a result of these themes. So I just wanted to highlight two or three categories, and one is computer peripherals. Super interesting category where the data that we've taken here is just from May onwards. But as you can see, there has been sort of a 2x increase in the overall conversations around computer peripherals, which has been led by wireless, discussions around wireless. So if you look at the factor trend, wireless as a discussion point has gone up a lot in the last 4 months. And what's interesting is this category did not take off immediately post lockdown, but it took, a few weeks before the conversation started surging. It's very, very interesting that the people who are talking about these are content creators. So there are more and more people now creating content, such as, you know, YouTubers or bloggers, and the conversations are also led by people who are working from home. And it's interesting that something like a mouse, which, you know, did not have a significant share in conversations, has today become one of the most discussed topic, you know, followed by headsets and also speakers. The next sort of category that I wanted to talk about was laptops. This is very, very interesting. And one of the things that we've seen is sort of the average age of buying a laptop has now shifted to 6 years. I would love to know all of your thoughts on, you know, how do you see this category expand? Like, it's the same people, but the category has now expanded. There's a net new set of kids, right, who we are buying laptops from. Every member in the family now has a laptop. Earlier, when we were going out to work, we were working in front of a computer. But again, now, laptop is the primary machine. And as you can see, there has been a consistent increase in conversations around laptops. Overall, since the lockdown, there is a 6x increase. Just from May itself, there is a 4x increase. What's interesting is also in terms of brands, Dell is the one that has seen a constant increase in sort of the share of voice. The brand share of voice chart here on the right. All other brands have maintained their share, but Dell has sort of gone up a lot during this period. So would love to hear thoughts on this. And then refrigerators. Now, refrigerators is an ever increasing trend. And it's not just refrigerator. We picked refrigerator, but there's a very, very interesting trend that we are seeing across, even vacuum cleaners or washing machines. Again, washing machines was a little bit of a luxury, and we never really needed it in India because we also have home help come in. But the entire home goods segment has seen a spike, and it's continuously seeing a spike. So would love to hear your thoughts there. And price continues to be the biggest purchase consideration factors for the home goods segment. I'll stop sharing now, but I just wanted to set context with this. So, Ranjeev, my first question is to you that what are your thoughts on what we saw in terms of laptops and specifically computer peripherals in your entire tenure of leading marketing at Samsung, HP, and Microsoft? Did you see times like these? Did you see times where the category was expanding? How would you sort of gauge and react to times like these?
Yeah, okay. Tamanna, it's really fantastic to be here on this platform with you and with all the others. I just wanted to start with saying that these are really special times in terms of COVID. It's affected everyone. And, there's no one that hasn't been impacted by COVID. And this impact has been huge. It's been unprecedented. Psychological impact, physical impact, economic impact. So, the way consumer electronics, the way we're talking about it, it's actually played a very critical role during this time. At this time, it's become front and center in terms of utility and improving quality of life for people because of the different kind of roles that they're having to play in the kind of, staying at home, working at home, all of those kind of things that you talked about. Now, you're right that the discretionary income has, been the one that's been hit a lot, and therefore the luxury super premium segment may have got constricted. So also, Tamanna, is the entry level. Entry level has also been hit across categories, I would imagine, with economic restrictions. But it's the premium and the mid segment. That's where consumers are finding a lot of value. So when you talk about laptops or you talk about peripherals or washing machines, refrigerators, people are now thinking, they've got a different mindset. They're thinking, should I really be spending less or should I be investing for the future? Because now they're thinking a little bit more long term and really improving their quality of life at home. And that's a very significant change in terms of consumer buying towards and the approach towards consumer electronics. When it comes to laptops, in my tenures in the previous companies, we were always struggling with the fact that the PC penetration and the laptop penetration is so low in India. Earlier, it used to be because fixed lines are not there, but now with internet connectivity, suddenly in this phase, it's become such a great help for people. The big difference is really in terms of the buying method. People have always in India wanted to be served. They want to go out to a store, want to interact with a retail person and understand the recommendation from that person. That's become very, very restrained now. And that's where the digital is really playing a big role. So today I just read one of the peripheral companies, which is a leader, was I saw that in your chart, even in India, has had a blowout quarter. And it's not coincidence because people are becoming very dependent on laptops, peripherals, and these categories. So I'm going to pause now with just those opening comments.
Thank you, Ranjeev. Thanks a lot. And I'm you noticed the company that has seen a spike. And I think Logitech is one of the companies that has seen a spike, and specifically in peripherals and very, very interesting times. Amit, my next question is for you, and I'll also take what Ranjeev said in terms of kind of investing for future and people as they're staying at home. There is, they do want convenience and they are looking to invest in their comfort. But specifically around, two themes which we're seeing. One is this whole cooking at home, right? Again, this just the whole sort of restaurant share came at home because we were locked down, and that led to a change in behavior from what we're seeing because people have now enjoyed that. Cooking at home, have tasted the benefits of sort of, fresh food and the gratification that you get by putting food on the table. It's interesting, like cake was the most searched term on Google, and cake is also coincidentally the most spoken about term in communities, right? Desserts have now moved on from Indian desserts to cakes, right? Ovenless cakes. A lot of fusion cooking, a lot of healthy cooking conversations have spiked also because of the lack of exercise, no matter how much we are exercising at home. So that is one theme, right? And with that, have you seen a surge in cooking appliances, and also any product innovations that you're looking to do? Because we now want to cook fast, we want to cook healthier, and we also have to take care of the cleaning up after the cooking. Any thoughts in that space?
Sure. So good evening, everyone. Thanks, Tamanna. Also, I think just going step back in and just referring to your slides, I think if you add one more slide to it, where are all these particular demand and penetration is coming? I think it actually completes the entire picture. And before I take into cooking or into other particular appliances as a part, one thing which has happened in last four and a half, five months is there's a lot of reverse migration that has happened. Most of the metros, if you actually see in India, people don't belong to those metros. And because of work from home, people have shifted to their particular home bases. Because in any ways, you have to work from home irrespective of whichever geographies that you actually represent doesn't make any difference. So you have actually moved to your particular native basis. When you have actually reached to your native basis, you realize that you don't have the basic necessity which you're actually operating when you are in any of the metros and the main markets are actually, staying in those markets. So for example, as Ranveer was talking about refrigerator or laptops or even in your peripherals, anything, you're not having that. If you see the data which actually talks about the Wi-Fi connection that has happened in tier 2 and tier 3 markets, that has gone by more than 300%. And it is nothing else, it's only because of the demand that has actually increased today. That there are places where people have not even thought of having a Wi-Fi, which is a 300 Mbps as a speed, just because today the need has actually arises. Now coming and relating to the point that you mentioned about cooking and all, and also in terms of, as you mentioned, that 6 year is the entry level for anybody to buy laptops, 10 year is the entry level for anybody who really wants to go for trimming and shaving, because you have no other option to go outside. Previously, the same age was between 15 and 16 years of age. What has happened is today, because of every constraint, every appliances has become part of your life. Coming to the kitchen, see, apart from cake, if you see the amount of recipe and people who are actually trying to put a lot of recipe videos on YouTube or recipe bloggers, you may talk about their entire particular, even a small blogger without naming any blogger, your particular reach and your particular viewership has actually increased by 6 to 7 times. And it can be as simple as how to prepare chapati. It is as simple as, because there are many, many households that have never thought of preparing their particular home, even a 2 times meal that can actually prepare, because you never felt of the need. You have help. Now the help is not coming. You have to do everything on your own. And as you rightly said, Tamanna, there are many people who have actually started trying to look how to use an appliance. That's the biggest search for the appliances and how to actually maintain the appliance. But as simple as that, in a mixer grinder, if one of my jars, there are 3 jars, and if I don't know, I've never been to a kitchen at all, I don't know which are these jars used for. People have gone to the level of searching what is the need for the second jar, what is a small jar will do, what's a wet dry grinding will differ from a dry grinding. And that is how actually increase the entire engagement in the kitchen. Also, if you see, one of the biggest point within the kitchen is your water purifier. You can't call anybody for service. You can't even ask. People have started calling, and there are many organizations who have started supplying online video support on how can you even change your candle, how can you get an alert whether the water is coming or not. What the point which I'm trying to make it, and what are the ducks that I'm trying to connect, is today everything has gone to do it yourself for every consumer. Nobody is dependent on whether a service guy will come. Even my basic premise, I can actually do it on my own, because it's a day-to-day need for me. It is something that I really need to do. And nobody knew about this black swan event can happen, and it can happen in future. So nobody knows. Nobody can predict that by any of the tools and analysis that you have. But one thing that you can actually be rest assured about yourself, the skills that you can actually learn today, how you can actually implement and how you can actually do in the entire. So people would have talked about work from home, but one thing which is also seen because of most of the appliances, work for home is also one of the biggest concepts that people have learned, that you should know how to work for your home without any help, without any external intervention. Your work for home has become one of the biggest attributes in the entire aspect what you learned in the last 4 or 5 months.
Sure, very interesting, Amit. So I'll take off another question from there, which, you know, is sort of for all of you. But this thing about do it yourself, you're absolutely right. The specific questions that have come up on how to use products, or how to even, like you said, use a jar, and a lot of training that is required. which is where like earlier people were stepping offline. We would go to retail stores, a salesperson would talk to us, explain it to us. Where do you think this explanation is now happening? People have shifted from offline. They've shifted digital, we know, but where digitally? Where would I now go and ask for a recommendation? And where would I get that support? I would love to hear all of your thoughts on that. Like, where are you tapping into insights as people have stepped digitally and providing support?
So I can start off. You know, I think more and more people want to know the experience of the product before they buy it. I think that's not an exclusive e-commerce requirement. It is a general buying requirement that has emerged very strongly in India for Indian consumers across categories. They want the experience even before they buy the product, and they can get that when they hear about it from others. But I think people also see through that if there is a celebrity endorsement or if there is, you know, someone who seems to be just talking about something, that that may not be that credible. So credibility and authenticity is very, very important in that voice that comes out. And therefore, what people really want to do is to go out and hear more people like themselves who are intentional about, you know, what anxiety they want to address or what problem they want to solve. Because this really gets us, Tamanna, right into the conversation on the middle of the funnel. Typically, at a time like this, when the category is itself growing, as Amit also talked about, and I also, you referred to other categories as well in consumer electronics, the one danger that's there that brands need to watch out for is brand preference. Because it's at that time that the choice factor can become quite different from regular times. And that choice factor can be based just on maybe availability, or it could be based on price, or it could be based on recommendation. This is the time when people are really wanting to tune in and understand where and you know, what kind of product, the nuances of the product that they want to pick up. And there's no better place than communities is my discovery, really, that communities, groups, this is where people, like-minded people, get together, and that's where they pick up what is really good for them and which is better. Is it this model or that model within the same brand, or one brand versus another brand? And those kind of things that can happen across categories with that voice coming in, which is a very authentic voice of their peers. I think that's a very purpose-led kind of communication that happens within communities. So this is something, you know, which is, I think, really happening at scale, and which is why it's reflecting in some of the slides that you probably showed, which is the number of conversations have gone up so much. I think it connects with that.
Sure, thanks. Thanks, Ranjeev. Sanjay, I wanted to get your thoughts. You know, this it's very interesting discussion that we're happening, and I think there's so many things to discuss across all the categories, but specifically for home appliances and monitors. Actually, monitors, and I didn't have it on my slides, but we've also seen a spike in monitors in terms of discussion. Right? Are you seeing that trend also? And again, home appliances, where there are specific queries, even for something like a, you know, washing machine, that it's not just sort of dirt removal, but also germ removal. There are specific questions around that, because, you know, especially for COVID, we are all worried that, you know, our clothes, even if we step out, how to make sure that our clothes are completely sanitized. So there are those specific queries coming with this increasing conversations for home appliances, specifically washing machine, vacuum. So on that and monitors, you know, what are your thoughts? And do you think this is an opportunity to build sort of a longer term connect with the customer now? Because, you know, this could be a large sort of share of wallet from a home appliance perspective.
Yeah, so good evening all. So basically what I will talk based on my personal experience of last 5 or 6 months, and some of the survey which we did before going to the market post lockdown, is basically we did some survey on SEC A and B, male 25 to 55. We wanted to know what is the general mood of the consumer and what they are looking for. So, you know, what I found that the new normal was actually normal. There, nothing changed. the consumer was still buying from offline. Though there was an increase on online sales, and almost I would say 20 to 22% there was increase in our online sale. Though this online portion for LG is not too high. You know, it is good for TV sales and mobile sales, but for home appliances, it contributes hardly 6 to 7% of our total sale. And during this sale, what we found that out of entire online consumer, around 38% consumers were buying online just due to the reason because they wanted to maintain social distancing. That was the main reason. Now, as you rightly mentioned about microwave oven, so the easy cook is the keyword which has a 110% search in the internet during this period. So everybody was mastering his cooking skills and wanted to impress the family. So this microwave oven was a dying category over the period. Every year, this microwave oven, we were observing a degrowth of around 25 to 30% continuously. It was taken over by induction cooker or some other, other mode of cooking. But suddenly there is a hike. You know, you will not believe we are observing around 170 to 200% growth in microwave oven category for LG Electronics during last 3-4 months. We don't have material for these. Dishwasher, which was a very small segment, because the buys are not there at the home, everybody need dishwasher. The dishwasher for us, the price range was 50,000 to 70,000 rupees. You know, whatever stocks we get, hardly it takes 1 or 2 hours to finish that stocks. I mean, there is a huge demand. Front loaders, washing machine, around 60 to 70% there is a growth in the front loaders. The biggest hike which we have observed is, you know, the TV sales. You know, we tried to find out what was the what people are worried about this. So around 97% people were worried about their mental health, health and hygiene, and safety of their families. So during this period, there was no new content for the your DTH channels. Ramayana started during that lockdown period. And it was the highest rated program during in the GEC category during that period. There was a total surge of 28% in OTT, the new OTT connections during that period. So the whole market, so the markets like UP, Patna, the MP Chhattisgarh, the other this areas, Rajasthan, where 50 to 60% sale was for 2D TVs. The full HD TVs, it shifted to the smart TVs because everybody required smart TVs because people were saving the money. You know, there was hardly any postponement of the sale. People were saving money for that was the period for the vacation period. So whole vacations were canceled. You cannot spend on eating out. Malls were closed, no scope for shopping. So there was a lot of money available with them and there was a need of all these products. Be it washing machine, be it refrigerator, like side-by-side refrigerator, that category has grown by 400 to 500% times in India for us. And that too, we do not have material. So if had it been the case, we had the material, we could have sold the more material product during these times. So I would say, you know, it's a golden period for our industry and for us because the same type kind of surge we have seen during the GST time when GST was imposed in India or at the Notbandi, that demonetization time because people had money, they just desperately wanted to buy the money. Till June, everything was closed. In July, there was a surge in sale, but even the factories were closed. So there was a big gap between demand and supply. Now, you know, the things are gradually smoothing up, but now the festivals are coming. So we have very high hopes during this festival time also for the appliances sale and TV sales. you know, this time we had a good longer period after Navratri, you know, Shraddh period to Navratri period. We had a good 1 month period now. Now this time the marriages were cancelled. You know, the Indian consumer durable industry and TV industry, particularly in north and east part of the India, it is a big wedding economy. You know, the marriage, wedding gifting. Now, there were earlier restriction of 50 guests you can invite. Now 100 guests. Still, there was a huge spending and overspending in weddings in northern India or eastern part or across the India. So now the people are saving the money. So they had a budget of X amount. They are increasing the budget of that amount for gifting the appliances or TVs. These cancelled weddings, now these are happening in November and December. So we are expecting, and recently government has also announced that benefit on tax because the LTA were not consumed, the benefit of LTA, the income tax benefit. So now one can buy 3 times of the appliances and electronics during this period and can avail. So many good things are happening. I would say this is the golden period for our industry. And I don't know next year how we will, you know, register a growth over this period. That's the reality I'm telling you.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, Sanjay. And it's very, very interesting, right? Somehow I was taking notes as you were talking about some of these things, because it seems like is the new category creation and expansion, right? Like there's just, it's changed a habit. So I'm sure that hopefully the growth issue is year on year growth still remains because our habits have now changed.
Like, so now, okay. There are two manufacturers like Samsung and LG worldwide for module, the panels. These modules can be used for to make the televisions or laptops or monitors or mobile phones. Currently, to sell the global demand for microwave for laptops and monitors is so high that we are not getting panels for TV. There's a acute shortage in the market for the TVs. That's the reality, and it has never happened. You know, I have 30 years of experience of this industry. I have never seen a price increase in televisions. It has always dropped. It has always dropped. Every year, 20 to 30% drop in TV has happened. But this time, from last 3 or 4 months, we have been increasing the price of TVs because there is huge demand and we do not have supply, and the material cost has gone up.
Very, very interesting. I think we're seeing that spike. So one thing we saw is a rise in entertainment-led communities, right, where people are talking. They're even discussing specific shows that they're watching, right? There's a Motu Patlu community which has 1.5 million members. So there is that discussion. But Vaibhav, over to you now, right? Like, would love to hear from you. How have you seen things change in your group post-COVID? Have the conversations changed? Have the number of people who are joining changed? And what are they talking about? So would love to hear from you.
Yeah, thank you, Tamanna, and good evening, everyone. Post-COVID, most of the people are, like in my community, are talking about like buying gaming rigs, monitors. And as Sanjay sir said, like people are buying TV this time. Okay. So what people are asking in the groups, like, is there any TV that I can buy, and the same TV I can also use Zoom by using a camera, or I can play games? Is there any TV for a high FPS games, or I can enjoy my computer on the same panel? So yeah, this kind of queries are like huge increase in this kind of queries. And of course, the mobile phones. Once in the lockdown, they are just suggestions. The students are asking, like, I wanted to start YouTube and community and website and study blog. But when the government started online sales, like there are huge increment in the questions, like which phone should I buy? What are the, like, these features I wanted in my phone, like good camera, 8 GB RAM, 128. So this kind of questions are increased post-COVID. And of course, the home appliances are also there. So, like, of course, people are buying dishwashers and microwave current time and the front-loaded washing machine. I hardly did top-loaded washing machine question, but most of the questions are related to front-loaded. So yeah, these are the questions that I can see after post-COVID.
And Vaibhav, who are these people? Like, why do you think they join your group to ask these questions? They can go and, you know, get this information elsewhere. But who are these people?
So of course, these are the people who are very tech enthusiasts. Okay, so they watch YouTube. They are on Facebook. They are on Instagram. But most of the people don't trust on YouTube because they are biased review for all the products. So they thought, why not? We can ask this question in community where I can get the honest answer for any product or for, you can say, honest review. Because there are many people who are using that product in that particular time. And so they can give the answer, like what are the things that company should improve, what are the things which is really good in this product. So people are like tech enthusiasts and they are eager to help you and they are giving you answers. And these are the like really honest answers, I should say, because they are not paid by any brand or any marketing campaign. So yeah, that's why people ask this question in the community.
And do you accept all the people who choose to join your community?
Of course not, because there are lots of spamming going on Facebook today. So first, once we get any request, so first we look into the profile. So if we find out, okay, this is a person which is suitable for our group, because of course we have some certain criteria to join the group. So once we find out, then only we accept the request. Otherwise, we directly reject them. And if anytime we found out any people are spamming in the group after the joining, we directly remove them and remove the post. So to make this community clean, so this is very important.
Sure. Sure. It really, yeah. So on an average, when we see the acceptance rate of Facebook groups is close to 60%, and there's no way to run a paid ad and increase Facebook groups. So that's interesting. Vaibhav, you said that, you know, they know these are honest answers and it's not promotion. So does this mean brands cannot interact with consumers in the community? I know you had mentioned about a campaign that you did for a brand. Just tell us a little bit more. How was that campaign? What happened?
Yeah, sure. Of course, brand can, of course, interact with people. Of course, there are chances. Like in when Xiaomi had to launch their MIUI 10. Okay, but it was MIUI 10, yeah. So they wanted beta tester. Of course, Xiaomi have a big community of Mi fans. But as I heard from Xiaomi social media team, like they are just people who you can serve anything and they will like, yeah, that's cool. That's okay. We can go with that. So Xiaomi offered me, like some of Xiaomi social media team offered me, okay, we wanted to promote this campaign in your group and we wanted beta testers for our MIUI. And then they promote this kind of form and they started promoting this beta tester requirement in my group. And they got good number of beta testers and they shared good amount of like review for their MIUI 10 and the apps related and all the feedback that a real consumer want to share with the brand. So brand can also improve their quality and they can also understand the real pain point of the consumers. Because sometimes what happens, you are doing marketing, you are getting like you are paying Facebook or the social media team for that, and you are not getting organic users. They are paid user and you are also not getting a very honest review. Because the people who are doing work on YouTube making content, they also want to interact with the brand. So of course, when they talk about phone, they will say, yeah, this phone is good, this brand is good. So they can get insight from the brand. But in community, these people are not there. The people, they will share what they want to share. So that's why. So and it was a very good campaign with Xiaomi, of course, I'll say. Like they got lots of new MIUI beta testers from our group.
What was very interesting for me, I actually just spoke to Vaibhav yesterday and I was asking him because he told me about this and I was very curious. I said, why did Xiaomi come to your group to get beta testers? Because they have one of the largest communities I think after Apple. So I said, why did they come to your community? And he said, because, you know, their community just has their fans. So they cannot recruit for beta testing. So they go to Facebook groups to recruit and to get feedback. So this was super interesting to me that while having their own thriving community, they are still going to this sort of organic set of people. But this was very interesting, Vaibhav. So today there's 1.8 billion people who meaningfully engage in groups every month. Facebook had their summit just last week where they released these numbers. There are 70 million people who are creating Facebook groups across all categories. We actually call it the best kept secret. I think YouTube, Instagram have become very, very important content dissemination channel. And I think Amit, as you also pointed out, for DIY, for, you know, there's a lot of instructional videos, content which could be posted, reviews. And that's one way where people are spending time online. But groups is then where we are at least seeing they're coming and asking for recommendations. And, you know, that actually brings me to my next question, that we've now seen all of the data that, you know, you guys have shared and, you know, I shared initially, that across, it seems like across categories in electronics, there is a spike. There is a spike in demand, surge in interest, and it is here to stay. Where are you all, which channels are you all tapping into get these insights, as well as increase spends to get in front of consumers meaningfully? So what specific digital channels are you tapping into for both insights as well as marketing digitally? This question is for the entire panel. So yeah, Amit, we can start with you.
Sure. So Tamanna, it is, if you see today, it is anything and everything. And that is how, which is today, online or digital is no more a medium. It's part of life today. So you can't say, I can only go in four or five different. And as you rightly talked about, today, nobody is actually targeting consumers. Everybody is targeting communities. So once you start targeting communities, then obviously everybody becomes your audiences. And it hardly makes any difference whom and what particular cycle of your particular journey is actually doing. And how it is actually making the difference is, your consumer decision journeys are actually now trying to change into consumer digital journeys. You have started mapping how their entire particular digital ecosystem in their particular life started moving. So anything and everything under the sun that is available for you today, you can actually tap it and you can find what's a meaningful conversation within that community that you can actually try to do. Because three things that has actually transpired, and which I also created one of the frameworks for doing that, which is a 3T framework, which is trust, transparency, and technology. That is what consumers are looking today. If you're actually able to trust in any of the communities and the groups that you call it are giving me that particular leeway of trust, is it a transparent platform where I can actually go and find my particular conversation meaningful, as a word of mouth meaningful, and how technology is actually trying to shape up all the three together? That is what I want to contribute at this point of time.
It's very interesting. I think speaking about trust and word of mouth, right? And you said organic word of mouth, which is now happening digitally. So again, would love to know, how are we measuring this organic word of mouth, or we call it share of voice, right? How do we measure the share of voice? You know, what are the new channels that you're looking to for measuring this share of voice, which is organic? Would love to hear from, you know, Amit, you or Sanjay or Ranjeev, just the question to the panel. I was hoping we can sort of conclude with this, that what are the, so that whoever's viewing this can get more insights on where should they now go to tap into this increasing demand, to engage meaningfully with consumers and, you know, get that sort of spike in growth, which also, you know, and answer consumers' questions. What are the channels that we should go to?
Look, I can go next. I think what Amit talked about was very interesting. He talked about the 3T model, and trust is a big part of that. However, trust is, is not something that you can just command or you demand. It's something that you earn. Trust is something that is built over time, but more importantly, there's a first step in that, particularly in the pandemic, in a time of crisis. Consumers really were floundering, which was a new way for them. And that's my view, that the brands that stood out were the ones that actually extended themselves to help. Now, how can you help? How can a brand extend itself, or how can a brand move and start talking to its consumers when retail is, you know, sort of constricted, etc.? It's really the online space, it's the digital, it's the communities where that engagement starts happening. Now, that can happen across the value chain of the four P's of marketing. You can have price offers, you can also have product innovation, you can have packaging changes, you can have delivery services, many different ways in which a brand can stand in. It can extend the warranty period. There are so many things that brands have done to help. When the brand comes in to help is when the relationship starts developing. And that's, the relationship is a precursor to developing trust. So it's not that you, you know, land on trust from day one. You have the number of steps that you have to put together to be able to get there, but it's just not possible to do even in the digital space without technology. And so the advantage that now we have is AI, ML, and the fact that, you know, we can work across huge scalable level. And if you're particularly looking at social media platforms, then you've really got to look at a scaled out model for doing that, because consumer will otherwise see through what you're trying to do. And if you're not in your purpose, and if you're not really centered around that, it's just writing out a check to some relief fund is not the only way to, you know, help out in this time. It is, how do you engage? How do you make quality of life better? And that's where people pick up those signals, those conversations, and they do that in the communities. And I feel, at least measuring that, understanding that, and shaping that in a way that you're still in your purpose and moving your brand in that right direction are the ways and the signals that you really want to align yourself towards. So that's my thought on this.
Tamanna, just to add on what Sarjeet said, I think what your answer looking for is one size doesn't fit for all. The measurement will not be happen from a X category that can be replicated to a Y category. So if in our particular parlance, if you operate in 32 categories, the same measurement will not be applicable from one category to 32 categories, because your consumer digital journeys are very different. Your consumer decision journeys are very, very different. And your consumer connect are very, very different. Even within the entire community of digital, your four P's, as Ranjit was talking, is absolutely changed today. So your four P's are traditionally has not changed to platform, process, your preferences and people. It has absolutely changed today. Keeping that in mind, you have to decide which category maps to your particular consumer decision journeys and how you can measure and how you can see the effectiveness of that. Technology is there. It is up to you how you use the technology to the best of your abilities, not only in terms of gaining insights, but also in terms of using those insights in terms of reaching out to customers, not because customer is five steps ahead that what you are thinking as a brand. That has to be the starting point for any conversation that you actually draw.
So, Tamanna, I would like to add something in this discussion, some interesting things which we did during this pandemic. As I've told you, post-lockdown, we decided how to connect the consumer and what to do now, or how to do our marketing during this time. You know, consumer were very sensitive at that time. So we wanted to know, we wanted to just gauge what is the actual mood of the consumer. So we started with a survey. And the results were that there were three things which were on the top of the mind of the consumer. First thing was the health and hygiene and safety of his family. That was across everywhere, each consumer, everybody. Around 97% of respondents said they are concerned about this. Second thing, and during that time, the patriotism. Because, you know, there was the India-China face-off and all these things were happening. So that was in the top of the mind during that time. And the third thing was the fear for the future. That 22% of the consumers said, no, we don't know currently if we buy any product or we invest on any product, what will happen if something goes wrong? I have to add. Because at that time, the hospitalization for any COVID infected person was mandatory. And there were huge cost of hospitalization. You know, the packages were there. So these were the three things. So we decided to go, not to spend money in any kind of media. We thought, let's talk about health and hygiene. how our products can help consumer to maintain this health and hygiene. Like we have a steam wash washing machine. Let's talk about that. How it can kill the bacteria, germs, and virus if due to some kind of bleeding or something, or our dishwasher, it's steam wash. And there was a very underrated feature in our water purifier. That was a digital sterilization. You know, our water purifier, it does not require any kind of physical touch to clean it. It can be digitally sterilized. So we started talking about these things on online, on various media. Then we, because I told you that that nationality, patriotism, all these feelings were too high. CSR was the activity which we thought, let's do this. And that was the time when community need us. And consumer, they prefer to purchase the product where we can, they can add some positive values. So we donated around 6,000 products in various quarantine centers and COVID wards. We talked, did a lot of PR for these, all these things. We established some of the, you know, laundries for police people. We distributed 1 million face shields to police. We did tie up with Akshaya Patra. We distributed 10 million food packets there. So we did a lot of PR activities so that, you know, we can connect to the consumer instead of doing a direct marketing of our products, because they are very sensitive during this time. They don't want to listen us. What, buy this, buy that, do this, do that. The third thing was the the fear for the future. You know, then for their mental health, we bundled our TVs with Netflix. Okay, we will give you this free. For the fear for the future, we were the first one to do the tie up with insurance company. Look, we will give you insurance if you buy our product. If something goes wrong, we do not require any kind of hospitalization bill. You just give us any government recognized laboratory test report that you are COVID positive, we will give you 50,000 rupees. No question asked. That was complimentary for each, if you buy any of our product. These things really helped us. You know, now there was asymptomatic patients are also there. So they, and people got this insurance claim. So we worked on all these three things. Parallelly, we thought now consumer cannot come to our stores. Now what we should do? We did this store on wheels. Okay.
Sir, I'm really sorry to intervene at this point, but I just have to remind that we have 10 minutes left and we have questions from the audience. May I just ask a couple of questions, or Tamanna, you can ask your last comment and then I can ask the questions.
Yeah. I just wanted to, this is very fascinating, Sanjay. I would actually love to connect even later and learn. This is a very, very structured approach to first understanding the problems, right? Which you did, the insight which you did through the survey, and then going all out and being there for the consumers, right? Answering their top of the mind, which is really what purpose-led marketing is, right? It's not about, I would love to connect later and understand that, you know, what were the channels that were used for this message outreach? This is the first time I'm hearing about this. I would have loved to kind of hear about this and spread the word in even other communities that, you know, we have access to. Would love to understand more, but this is fascinating. I think just acting so fast, doing a survey and then, getting on to the next steps. Wheat is actually another brand which did this. They did this, and I know this because they did it across communities, but they launched a whole Wheat Cares initiative where, again, you know, beauty at home also became a big challenge. And the top things that came out was people don't know how to do certain beauty regime at home, right? So how to even do hair removal at home. So they brought in experts and dermatologists and also beauty experts and just went all out with this messaging. But it's great to see brands stepping up, right? And I think now is the time for purpose-led marketing, thinking about building long-term connect with the consumer. Thank you. I've thoroughly enjoyed this discussion and so many like non-stop notes I've taken. I'm going to reach out to each one of you. And we'll also be releasing a report on the insights for electronics, in which would love to take some inputs from all of you as well. We'll be releasing that end of the month. Yes.
Right. Rohit, I want to ask my first question, the audience question. Mr. Tiwari, to you, one of the questions is that how is the festive season looking like, you know, for the brands, electronic brands right now? Name is not given, it's an anonymous question.
Very good. So festival, I think there's quite a good buzz in the market when it comes to festivals, in terms of the festival season. If you see from the overall upbeat of the consumer sentiments are quite good in terms of the way people are, you can actually gauge it through a lot of people engagement that are happening. So festival looks quite good, but I think the last mile would depend upon how does you actually translate and how does the things move into the entire preference that consumer look for. But as of now, if you see, there's a lot of buzz in the market in terms of festivals. I think so.
Right, right. Tamanna, to you, the question is, how much time does it take for a brand to get ROI from the community? And there's an added question, how have you defined the metrics as far as, you know, building that ROI for the community building is concerned?
Sure. So Rohil, I'll take the second part first, right? What are the metrics in terms of ROI? So the beauty of a community is there are conversations. It's not a broadcast or just content dissemination. There's two-way conversations. So the measurement actually happens right from mid to bottom of the funnel, starting from basic engagement down to increase in category conversations, increase in brand conversations or brand share of voice. And the biggest metric that we want to move is this organic word of mouth or share of voice, right? And that's sort of how we measure. And then there's conversion-led objectives such as, you know, sampling or research or opt-ins, etc. The time that it takes. So typically, you know, when an admin goes with a message, like how Vaibhav said, it was a specific objective that was defined. That was to recruit beta testers. The admin goes out with the message. The message is super relevant because the members are there to talk about that topic. If people are asking that is which washing machine to use, not just for removing dirt, but for germ kill, and we go with that information, then there's more conversations. Okay, so how do I use it? Is this right? So it's pretty... It could be a week, 2 weeks, but usually these are sustained activities where brands decide to do X number of interventions over a period of 6 months or 12 months with different messages.
Right. Mr. Chitkara, I also want to come to you with the same question, which I also posed to Mr. Singh, which is that Pallavi is asking, the question is to both of you, that what is the key takeaway from this pandemic for brands like yours? I can start with you, Mr. Chitkara, yes.
You know, the biggest takeaway from this pandemic is for my business is like there are only 10% things which can affect your business, but 90% is the business depend how you react to that situation. You know, one way was that when we used to talk to our team, they said, sir, ab to kya hoga, ab to billing to kuch ho hi nahi sakta, we are totally, they have given up. But the biggest takeaway is you will have to innovate in each situation. Like we have around 10,000 sales promoter across the India. They were sitting at home. We started them. You start creating a lead during this time. You call to your consumer, ask their health, ask about their product services. We sold more than 1 lakh product during this time just by creating telephone calls.
Right. Right. Great. Yes, Mr. Singh, how would you add to it?
I think, you know, the crisis is the time when the true element of a company, the culture, the ethos comes to life. And that's where you get to know what really the brand is about. Has the brand really stepped out of its own circle of suffering to actually extend itself to firstly those retailers? You know, think about them and their families. Think about those assistants who are there and their families and those who are dependent on the, and think about your consumers. Think about your channel partners and actually start working out programs to be able to help them. Because it, no matter what we say, at least who we are talking about here, the large brands operating in consumer electronics are very blessed to be in the position to be able to extend that help. And the economy does depend to a very large extent on brands like this. So I would say this is a time to really go beyond yourself and really think about that. And then in that, you discover new ways of communicating, which is what the topic is really about. How do you engage your consumers? How do you help them out? How do you build relationships? And then how do you get trust? Don't think about just the sales and the billing and things like that. This is not the time for that. That will happen. The categories that will go up will go up. The point is, will your brand be preferred or not? If you've been able to do a good job of stepping out of yourself, then you know the results will be there. So that's my thought.
Right. Mr. Mishra, for you, creating sticky content is one of the, you know, big challenges always been there, you know. How are you enabling that for your community? How have you made your community so loyal to the content that you make?
Okay, so first thing is what people want in community to clean. Like no random content, no spamming. So this is the most important thing in our community. So once you get this thing, okay, then people start talking to each other. And when every time when you post, like you have to show like you are care about your people in your community. And every time when you post anything, it's automatically like a sticky content for our consumers, for the users who are actually in that community.
Right.
So you just have to interact with them. Like if someone asking any question, no matter you have time or not, but you should answer that question. So that defines like how you care about your people in community.
Right. Perfect. I'll leave it to you, Ms. Damaja, to ask. Last, we have like a television panel type, 1 minute, 2 minutes, so you can take over. Over to you.
So just one last question. Are there any thoughts on building your own community?
Yeah,
this is
like
for the entire panel. Sorry.
Yeah. So Tamanna, it is not a, if I may go, I think it is not about building the community, but the bigger challenge is sustaining that community. It is very easy to build a community, but it's very tough to sustain and at least engage that community. And if you see the communities that are successful and the communities which are really not successful and doing well, the proportion is huge. It is 1:100 proportion that is there. Second thing is, what is the purpose of that community? I think that has to be defined first. And what is that actually attribution that goes to the brand? It is not about just because of fancy community building that you want to do, you create a community and after 5 months inside that it's of no use. So entire effort, time, money spent is actually goes for a toss. So if you really want to build a community, purpose has to be defined. And do you have a sustainable and scalable plan to really have an engagement and a meaningful community? Then it makes sense. Otherwise, it is just one particular asset that you're trying to make and create in your particular pool of assets that you actually do. That's my thought on that.
Thanks. Would love to hear other panelists' views on this. I think it's absolutely right, Amit. Without like all other assets, there needs to be objective, purpose defined. It has to be sustainable, scalable, and hopefully the biggest source of ROI. But would love to hear other panelists' thoughts on this.
Well, I can comment on this. I'm not really practicing anymore, but you know, if I was to look at this in terms of, some advice that I would give to someone, I would first participate in communities, bring this into your mainline thinking about as a part of your media mix and think about how you actually engage with consumers. And then the decision whether to build out your own store or participate in a mall, in that akin to that kind of an example, first I would test out the waters in community that exists and see what values can be derived there. But then depends on the strategic objective of the brand. And I cannot think of anything that's more important than engaging consumers. Consumers are at the center of everything that a brand needs to do, at least in the consumer space. So I would imagine this should really come onto the strategic map and start executing towards it and start taking some steps towards building out communities.
Thanks, Ranjeev. So I think it's clear, right? The two or three things that have clearly come out is there is it's a never before time for the entire sort of electronics space, right? In this category, and in uncertain times like these, people are propelling online, they are propelling towards smaller, safer communities and do value the inputs and camaraderie in these channels. It's very interesting to see how brands have tapped into and done research surveys and then gone on and engaged meaningfully with the consumers, right? Rather than just sales ads. So super interesting. I will reach out to all of you for your inputs, which we can include in our report that we're releasing end of this month. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Ms. Damecha. Thank you, Sir Amit Ji, Ranjivit Singh Ji, Sanjay Ji, Weber Ji. I'm so sorry if I mispronounced any name. Thank you very much for joining us on this conversation, and we hope to join you and invite you to more of such webinars. Thanks again.
Thank you so much. You have been very good as a host in terms of Rohil. Always, thank you so much. Always been a good host. Thanks for always inviting us. Thank you so much. Thanks all the panelists. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah, it's great being here.